Asha Devon is a writer and campaigner who herself suffered with anxiety and for a time was the children's mental health czar. She's calling for mental health to be as strong a part of the school curriculum as physical health. And she told me earlier that often adults completely misjudge what's triggering young people's problems.
What young people are feeding back to me is that their parents and teachers assume that the reason that they're experiencing anxiety has to do with social media. And whilst they might acknowledge that that is a problem, they say that academic pressure, anxiety around testing, fears about not being able to get a job when they leave education and not being able to get on the housing ladder are far more prevalent and far more pressing for them than anything that's happening on their smartphone.
You perhaps don't feel that in general schools are doing enough. What more could and should they be doing?
It's not that I don't believe that schools are doing enough or school staff. The structure of our society, and in particular our education system, is not conducive to well-being. If you think of mental health as existing in three layers, so you've got promotion of good mental health, acknowledging that everyone has a mental health and that will fluctuate throughout our lives, that's the first layer. The third top layer is if you're mentally ill and you require medical intervention. And the middle layer is helping people who, it's not bad enough that they need therapy, but they need some kind of intervention. The problem is that people are getting stuck on the second layer because children and adolescent mental health services are woefully underfunded. So in some areas of the country, there are children who have attempted suicide multiple times who are not qualifying for an appointment with therapists. So teachers who are very switched on, in my experience, and can listen non-judgmentally, but who aren't therapists, they're not psychologists, are being expected to deal with issues which are outside of their remit. And that is what the government need to get on and sort out.
And yet the government does say, and has been saying for some time now, that mental health is a priority for the nation and money will follow that belief. So what, you're not seeing it on the ground?
It's true to say, for example, that the government has put in place more mental health nurses than any other government. However, they've also cut more mental health staff than any other government. And what they've put in place is only one third of what they cut. So it's still not enough. The 1.4 billion that they pledged for young people's mental health isn't ring-fenced, meaning that when it gets to local authority level, that local council has choices over how it can spend it. So Luciana Berger, who is the Shadow Minister for Mental Health, found that only 50% of local authorities had increased their spending on mental health in real terms since the government have claimed that it's a priority.
Natasha Devon, well, last month the government announced